Hello, hello, mic test. Hello everyone, I'm Ritvik the Shora and I'm back with a new video and some new learnings. If you're interested to know about the best technical analysis library in Python, then you're at the right place. Today we will talk about the Pandas TA library and why I think that this library is the best technical analysis library in Python. Scan this QR code and I have already pasted this code that I'll build today in this video. You can copy the code from that Telegram channel and refer it while watching this video. So before we start building the model, if you are new around here, on this channel I turn my viewers into a successful financial programmers. Here I upload videos related to trading bots, backtesting, some amazing finance APIs, etc, etc. So if this is something you are interested in, then smash on the subscribe button and hit on the bell icon. And I'll reach some lucky subscribers with a surprise gift. You give me a click, I give you a chance to win that surprise. And if you want a free access of my Google Drive where I will save this code, and I've also saved many more codes like my code on TradingBot, algo trading strategies, etc, etc, then I'll just tell you a way how to get a free access of my Google Drive. This is the documentation of Pandas TA. I'll paste the link in the description box. And the thing that makes it special is that it covers more than 130 technical indicators, which is amazing. But apart from that, there's one thing which actually makes it really, really cool, and that makes this library the best in technical analysis, is that it has something called strategy class. We'll talk about this thing in detail. Another cool thing about this library is that it has an amazing interaction with Pandas library and also the 𝐈𝐦𝐩𝐵 library. 𝐈𝐦𝐩𝐵 represents to technical analysis library. Most of you would know that I have already covered a video on 𝐈𝐦𝐩𝐵, and if you have not watched that video, I highly recommend you to watch that video. It's an amazing library to implement technical analysis on trading bots. You can click on this I button to watch that video. Also, it has a lot of additional technical indicators which are not actually available on 𝐈𝐦𝐩𝐵 library, such as Ichimoku, Heikinashi, etc. And talking about Ichimoku, it is becoming one of my favorite technical indicator, and definitely I'll cover a trading bot on this technical indicator for sure in future. So let's start working on this library. We'll start with installing Pandas TA. So pip install Pandas TA. I'm actually using Google Colab to record this video. You can use any other platform such as Anaconda or any other things as well. And as I mentioned before, it has a very good interaction with the 𝐈𝐦𝐩𝐵 library. So let's install 𝐈𝐦𝐩𝐵 library as well. So this is the code that we write to install 𝐈𝐦𝐩𝐵 library in Google Colab. If you want to see how to install it in different platforms, refer to my previous video on 𝐈𝐦𝐩𝐵 library. Lastly, I installed YFinance. It gives me the historical pricing data using Yahoo Finance of different tickers, I would say different companies. Before going to the special thing about this library, let's just see the basic functionality of this library. I'm actually importing these three libraries here. So let's start with an empty data frame, which is df is equal to pd dot data frame. And then the interaction with Pandas library, it works like we can use technical and analysis this Pandas TA library over the Pandas data frame. So it can be like df.ta dot, and then let's see, ticker Apple, and then let's make the period to be equal to 5 years, right? As simple as that. If I run this cell, you can see that I've got this entire data frame of the historical prices of Apple. Simple. Now we can use this library to add different columns of different technical indicators on this data frame. So in order to do that, what we will do is df.ta, and then say I need log return, and then I make cumulative is equal to true and append is equal to true, which are the parameters that are required for this indicators. And then if I run this cell, you can see that the cumulative log return is has come in the end. It's a basic functionality. We can use some basic manipulation, Pandas manipulation, to do this thing. And in order to get the list of, or I would say the entire universe of all the technical indicators for which are actually inside this Pandas TA library, then what we need to do is df.ta and then indicators. You can see that you have this entire universe of the technical indicators that you can use. If you can see, I could see Arun technical indicator here. If you remember, I made a trading bot using Arun oscillator technical indicator, and that made a very good return, and that video is actually one of my best video on this YouTube channel. Just click on this I button to watch that video. If we want a list of all this indicators, and it's simple, we just need to do this thing, which is like df.t and the indicators as list is equal to true, and then this one. Now this list can be used to do iterations for different technical indicators for your analysis. It's amazing. So as of now, you could see that it's another technical and analysis library, but the thing that makes it special is this functionality. I'll go here quickly to the strategies, Pandas TA strategies. Now what is strategy? Now basically in this thing, we can make a template of all the technical indicators that are actually our favorite technical indicators, and we want to use those technical indicators more than one time. In that case, you can make a strategy of all the technical indicators, and then you just need to call that function in order to have all the technical indicators that you wanted. I'll just go through this one. For example, I want to make a custom strategy, and then in that case, the name of the strategy can be something, description, these are not important. So that the parameters that I want for the technical analysis are, for example, in this case, SMA, length is 50, SMA, length of 200, B bands, RSI, etc. Then I just need to run this, which is df.ta and then dot strategy and then custom strategy, which will automatically have all the columns in the end of the data frame. So let's just copy this and paste it here. If I do it like this, if I run this cell and then run df, you could see that all the indicators that I mentioned in the strategy have come in the data frame, which is an amazing thing. So what I need to do here is basically I just need to work on this thing and then forget about the rest of the things. And this is also just one time work. I'll just paste it somewhere. I'll just paste this list somewhere, and then I'll just keep on using this list for my future references. Do you think does it make it special? Right? Yeah, it does make it special, because I don't think that a functionality like this one is available in any of the available technical indicator libraries. Now another thing that you can see is that they have made some of the strategies that are common, and then you can directly use those strategies. But for example, in this case, categorical, the momentum strategy and all the strategies, the common strategy, all strategy, it will have all the technical indicators in the end of the data frame, which will actually it will take a lot of time to run this code, but it will have all the indicators. But I'm not interested in all the indicators. I would be interested in three or four indicators that are my favorite indicators. So definitely I should consider making a custom strategy. But there's another great thing about this library is to follow some of the styles of technical indicators. I'll show it to you here. So if I write df.ta.categories, you can see that I have a list of all the types of strategies that are available on this platform. And in order to select, for example, I like momentum, in order to have this momentum strategy and have all the technical indicators that are related to the momentum strategy in the end of all of our data frame, that what we need to do is basically df.ta and then dot strategy and then momentum. That's it. If I run this cell and then write df, you can see that we have 90 columns with us right now, and we have got all the technical indicators which are actually related to the momentum strategy. And I think this thing makes this library really, really amazing, because now we can use different types of strategies for our trading main strategy. And lastly, if you are interested to get the CAGR or the maximum drawdown, the Kalman ratio, Sharpe ratio, Sortinel ratio, it's really, really simple to implement in this library. I really love this library, and if you like this library, then just click on like button and all your likes will directly revert to the work that is being done by developers of the Pandas TA library, and it is a way for all of us to support these people. Now I'll tell you about the product that I've made for you, which will actually make your life easy. But before that, actually I'm getting a lot of requests on making videos on Indian stock market. If you want me to cover videos on Indian stock market, then just please mention in the comment box. Just write Indian stock data in Python. If the number of comments with this comment is a lot, then yeah, I'll definitely consider making videos on Indian stock market as well. How to get a free access of my Google Drive? Before that, if you like my work, then please consider becoming a Patreon member. You can see that there are three levels over there, and I provide different services on different levels. very soon I am planning to hire someone who will manage this Patreon account, because I can see that there are many members who are benefiting from the services that I provide on this thing, and I'm actually targeting Patreon to be one of the most important domain for my working space. So yeah, if you consider, please you can pick one of them, and you can support me by making your contribution. Now, in order to make your lives easy, guys, I have made a product for you, and this is only available to my subscribers, which this code will be saved in my Google Drive, and you'll very soon get to know how to get free access of my Google Drive. So I'm using Google Colab again for here, installing all these libraries. So this code will actually give all the required strategies for that you want to be the part of your analysis. So what we need to do here is just run this code. It will ask for the ticker. For example, I am interested in MSFT this time. Then just specify the time period, say 5 years. So we've got the entire data frame. Now this will actually help you to get the required this thing. So mention all the strategies you want to include in the data frame, separated by commas. Don't provide any spaces after or before comma. Make sure you check the spelling. So these are all the strategies. If you remember, these are all the strategies which are available. So for example, I'm interested in momentum and volume without any spaces. Volume, just we need to press enter, and what you'll see that you have got all the columns in the end of the data of this data frame. Now this code will be saved in my Google Drive. In order to get a free access of my Google Drive, you just need to subscribe to my YouTube channel and then click on this access to my Google Drive button. Over there, just follow some of the steps and click on this Google form link, provide some basic details, and I'll be using this email address to give a free access of my Google Drive. Thank you so much for watching this video till the end. You can click here to subscribe to my YouTube channel, and over there you can see how I use TA-Lib library to do some amazing stuff, and over there you can see how I made this Bitcoin day trading bot, which actually generated a lot of return. If you want to support me, then you can click on this link below, which is the Patreon link, and then pick one of the subscription model. Thank you so much. I'll see you in the next video.